A big thanks to MSI and Corsair for sponsoring our Computex 2018 coverage. Check out Corsair's fancy new Vengeance RGB memory, and if you're thinking of upgrading your gaming monitor, MSI Optics MPG curved gaming monitors come back with a 144Hz refresh rate, 1800i curvature, and up to 1440p resolution. For a limited time, they include a free SteelSeries mousepad and Steam gift card with every purchase in selected countries. See the link in the description to upgrade your game with MSI. Welcome back to Hardware Unboxed. We're here at Computex 2018 in front of the MSI booth that you can see over there. And we're just going to be taking a look at some of their latest consumer products, like their monitors, some of their laptops, a couple of their desktop systems, peripherals, fans. They've even got a case here that we're going to be taking a look at. So let's get straight to it. Okay, so we're here with MSI's first ever G-Sync monitor. It's the Oculux NXG251. It's a 24.5-inch 1080p 240Hz monitor designed for the esports market. Really excited to see MSI getting into the G-Sync monitor market. I reckon they'll be making some cool panels in the future as well, so stay tuned. Other features you get with the NXG251 include a 0.5 millisecond response time, which MSI was particularly proud of. It'll be interesting to see whether that claim holds up under testing, but considering it's a TN panel, I'm sure it'll be right up there in terms of response time. It also features MSI's Mystic lighting on the rear, and while the design is more on the basic end as far as monitors go, there's nothing to distract you while you slay foes in Fortnite at 240fps. Unfortunately, there's no word on pricing or availability just yet, though. So here's one of the most exciting MSI monitors that they've announced at the show. This is the MAG491C, another super long product name, but it is a 49-inch ultra-wide panel. Of course, it's 3840 by 1080, using that same Samsung panel that we've seen on the existing FreeSync 2 monitors. This monitor is just FreeSync, Display HDR 400 certified, but it's nice to see that MSI is expanding into the ultra-wide category. They've already got plenty of 16:9 displays, but this particular model should be really good for those that love that sort of double-wide 1080p. Previously called it a bit stupidly wide, but it's a nice-looking monitor here from MSI. Of course, because we are looking at that same Samsung panel we've previously seen, the MAG491C is VA with an 1800i curve, 3000:1 contrast ratio, and a maximum refresh rate of 144Hz. Maximum brightness is listed at 400 nits, and the design looks pretty nice, I reckon, for such a huge display. Again, we'll learn more about pricing and availability soon. Okay, so we're here with one of MSI's new monitors that they've announced at Computex 2018. This is the Optics MAG271CR. Bloody monitor names, they are impossible to remember. There's actually three variants of this monitor that are coming out. This one here is the 27-inch 1080p 144Hz. There's also a 27-inch 1440p 144Hz and a 24-inch or 24.5-inch 1080p 144Hz. So the MAG271 is a minor upgrade over the MAG270. The main new features are there's some new RGB-related features. You can either get this monitor with RGB or now a new without RGB model. And also they've completely upgraded their software, so you can not only control the on-screen display elements directly through the computer, but also you can change the RGB elements on the back. So a couple of neat improvements there, but again, just minor updates at the moment. I was told the MAG271 and MAG241 will be the exact same price as the older MAG27CQ and MAG24C models. However, you do get those minor upgrades, so look out for them on the market soon. Oh, and you can even control the RGB lighting and OSD controls using a smartphone app, which means absolutely no fiddling with the difficult-to-navigate OSD menu. So that's a pretty nice touch there from MSI. And before I head into talking about the laptops, I should also mention that MSI is preparing a selection of high end monitors that will fall under the MEG line. Currently we have the entry-level MAG products I've just been talking about, the upper mid-tier MPG monitors like I've previously reviewed, and now soon we'll be getting MEG monitors. There's no word on the exact high-end MEG monitors we'll be getting, but they should be ready later in the year. Alright, so we're here with the brand new MSI GF63 laptop. This is their more entry-level but still thin and light gaming laptop with slim bezels. It comes with 8th gen Intel Core i7 processors like the 8750H. And of course, you also get up to GTX 1050 Ti graphics. I have also heard that there might be 1060 graphics available in some markets like Australia, but this model here on show currently has the 1050 Ti inside. You're also getting a 15.6-inch 1080p display on this bad boy, and the entire system weighs just 1.8 kilograms or thereabouts, with a thickness under 22 millimeters, which is certainly slimmer and lighter than competing budget gaming systems. While not an entirely metal chassis, MSI has used metal for the lid and around the keyboard, which looks great, and the plastic underside helps keep the weight down. MSI tells me this laptop should retail for a touch under $1,000 US and will be available later this month. So this is another one of MSI's new laptops that they're showing off from their Prestige series. This is the PS42. It's a 14-inch laptop. Again, you can see the super slim bezels, and it comes with powerful hardware as well, including MX150 dedicated graphics and I believe Core i7 processors. So another really nice looking laptop from MSI, and I'm excited to check that one out as soon as possible. And you can see why I'd be interested in checking out the PS42. It's definitely MSI's nicest ultrabook-style laptop chassis yet, with silver metal everywhere and none of the typical MSI red and black color scheme that we're perhaps all a bit sick of at the moment. The keyboard is great to type on, there's an integrated fingerprint reader in the touchpad, and you also get a couple of USB-C ports. Plus, the battery allegedly lasts around 10 hours. There's no exact pricing or launch time frame for this laptop, but it should be out later in the year. MSI also had a range of other cool stuff on show, including a new case that they've actually previously announced, as it turns out, called the Mag Pylon. However, this is the first time we've seen the case in person, and I reckon it looks pretty good, especially with MSI's brand new Torx RGB fans in the front, which will be sold separately at a later date. MSI didn't want to talk about this case all that much, which is a bit of a surprise considering it's much more than just a basic entry-level product with tempered glass and some nice-looking aesthetics, but they did say it should cost around $100 US when it goes on sale in the next couple of months. They also had a few desktop PCs on show, the highlight of which was the Trident A, an 11-litre mini PC with a hinged tempered glass side panel for easy component access. Inside, you get up to an Intel Core i7 8700 processor, up to GeForce GTX 1080 Ti graphics, two M.2 slots plus a further two 2.5-inch drive bays, and either a 450-watt or 600-watt SFX power supply. I reckon it's MSI's best-looking mini PC yet, and it again includes one of their new RGB fans. Alright, that's it for the MSI booth at Computex in 2018. Make sure you like this video and subscribe for the rest of our Computex coverage in the next few days. Big thanks to MSI and Corsair for helping us out with our Computex coverage, and I'll catch you in the next one.